Welcome back. Some sad news this week. Sony will not be attending E3, or at least doesn't have a press conference. It's the first time in 25 years Sony is not there doing a press conference. And there are so many rumors around the world saying that Sony doesn't give a shit anymore. They have become arrogant. You know, they don't need to do it. They don't have anything to show, there are no games for the PlayStation 4 coming out. But of course, one of the biggest rumors is PlayStation 5 is coming up and they want to announce it the way they want to announce it. What my take on this is, yes, it's kind of both ways. Not only does Sony not have anything big new to show, and they think probably that their show is for the big exclusive games. And last year, people were a little bit disappointed. Like, Ghost of Tsushima looked really nice, but I mean, that was pretty much it. And, you know, we all know what games are coming up, like Death Stranding, The Last of Us, maybe Evil Remake. It looks really cool, by the way. And of course, Days Gone, Ghost of Tsushima, even though that probably will be like a cross-gen game because it did look really good. Maybe a little bit too good, even for PlayStation 4 Pro to come out. So yes, Sony probably does not have anything big to show. And you have to understand that doing a press conference at E3 probably cost a huge amount of money, and time to set everything up. And they probably think it's not worth their time, our time, and their money if they don't really have any significance to show. Now, the second is, yes, the PlayStation 5 announcement is coming up. Many rumors are pointing towards a 2019 mid till end announcement and sort of March, April, 2020 release. I personally would be really happy if that would be the case. It means that we have like a year and a half full of PS4 still, and they have enough time, like Guerrilla Games and all their other developers have enough time to really make sure that the launch games are on time and are good. They definitely do not want a second PS4 release, because even though the system sold a lot of units, it's mostly because Nintendo and Microsoft fucked it up. Because gaming wise, I mean, let's be honest, Killzone Shadowfall was, yeah, and Infamous Second Son was really good, but that's it. It's nothing compared to how Nintendo launched the Switch. So Sony is probably going to release the PlayStation 5 in 2020, something I have been saying for a long, long, long ass time. And they probably just want to make sure that the PlayStation 5 is running, it's you know, as best as it can be, and that they have stuff to show. So we could see like a 2019 PSX reveal maybe, or a little, or their own reveal that they also have done with PS4 Pro. It really sucks that Sony is skipping E3. I think one of the biggest main events every year for gamers and gaming alike is E3. I really liked it. I really like it. I hope E3 is not going away. But yes, that is my take on why Sony is not attending E3, at least not in a press conference for the first time. Leave it in the comments below. What do you think why Sony is not having a press conference? Like, share, comment, and subscribe. And like always, you're gonna see me next time.